Back in 1855, the state of Florida was young and bold, and living deep in the Everglades was a handful of Seminoles. Billy Bowlegs was a peaceful chief who made his living off the land. He didn't like the ways and he wanted to stay, far removed from the white man. Bill had a garden where he grew some corn, and squash and pumpkins and beans, but his pride and joy since he was a boy was a grove of big banana trees. And old Bill would fight for what he thought was right, and he got as mad as can be that fateful day that he was away and they chopped down his banana tree. A survey team went into the swamp with a bold and brilliant plan to dig some canals and build some roads and drain that fertile land. They happened on Billy Bowlegs' garden one day while he was gone. They picked all the fruit and they chopped down the trees and they left it bare as a bone. Well, old Bill got just as mad as a snake when he saw what they had done. He said, "You'll pay," but they laughed it away and said, "We were just having fun." But old Bill would fight for what he thought was right, and he got as mad as can be that fateful day that he was away and he chopped down his banana tree. Bill tried hard to control his wrath, he used a lot of restraint, but in the end the warpath would win, Bowlegs would wear war paint. Now this little tale I'm telling you is not just mere folklore. That fateful day put us on the way to the Third Seminole War. Because Bill would fight for what he thought was right, and he got as mad as can be that fateful day that he was away and they chopped down his banana tree. That fateful day that he was away and they chopped down his banana tree.